Welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now today I'm going to talk about Muta, aka the bedbug. Don't worry, I'll tell you why I'm named bedbug. See, Muta is a youth who come from a lineage of 87s. A bloodline that has taken so many lives, I don't even think you can put the accurate number upon it. See, Muta is one of my strongest critics. Most Klansmen, no matter how bad them be, no matter how much victims them have, normally, they are not stupid enough to publicly walk out and tell people what they might go do to me. But Muta isn't very bright. Muta has been constantly walking up and down, shouting panta pan vice like a madman. I tell everybody where I see. People in America here, people in England here, people in Canada, like the whole diaspora, man. Anybody will link to Spanish Town, Muta need to tell them, say. Anytime him catch me, I'm going to murder, not just me, but my family. See, it's interesting. Why would Muta behave like that? Well, Muta resides in a place where it's very difficult for the security forces and get to him. Muta feels very confident, or he felt very confident, not anymore. Before we go into what happened to Lico Muta, let me tell you a quick backstory. See, Muta, his father is Errol Miller. Oh no, not that Errol Miller. Right. Errol Miller, the Klansman, aka Crackers. Now, Errol Miller, or Crackers, was killed by none other than somebody we hear me talk about numerous times. City Puss, right, and the next 87 devil youth were convicted of killing Errol Miller. So City Puss already there behind bars, but the sentence them get wasn't really a flingway sentence. So he's still a part of the upcoming trial. But even though City Puss killed Crackers, and Crackers is Muta's father, Crackers is Smoke his father, Crackers is Hezzy's father, he was also Papu's father. The same Muta end up come start take orders from City Puss. Yes, the man will kill him father. Till it got to a point where there was a falling out. City Puss laugh off him and tell him say I'm a fool cause him kill him father and him start giving orders, you know. But right now they're not too good. Because Lico Muta is all grown up. You see, Smokey and Ezzy, they're behind bars. They're a part of the upcoming Klansman trial. And Papu dead. Police kill him. Lico Muta cause beer problem. All over Waterloo Lane inside. Rivoli, Bucktown and them place them. See, Lico Muta is a hothead. If you even walk past on a hill Muta and in front of him in a way with them appease, with appease them, they will step to you. That's how them youth are behave. But let me come back around to the threats. Muta say I'm gonna kill me and my family. Matter of fact, I was not supposed to make it to the end of the year. Well, him have 2 days left. I guess I'm gonna have to find somebody else to carry out the works for him. Because you see, Muta's confidence that him couldn't get fined, right? Muta's confidence that which part him lay low, but he can't get to him, was abruptly shaken up early Saturday morning. When a team from both the police and the JDF went to pay Muta a visit. Muta was very shocked. Muta didn't know if nobody could have found him. See, Muta was feeling really good because not too long ago, over a place named Bucktown, Muta killed a youth named Cabo. And this made little Muta feel on top of the world. See them? Brother them gone, but I'm here on the place now. I'm killing much people. I'm leaving in it. You know, Christmas. Christmas just passed. I'm moving on the boxing day now. I don't gonna relax with him kerosene. Or like a thief in the night. Here comes security forces. Amongst the kerosene, we're Muta there. Guess what the kerosene said? She didn't know, he's not there. But he was there. People, guess where Muta was? Guess where the big bad feared Muta was? Muta on that bed of hide. Muta on the bed of hide. Bedbug? Muta? Muta, suppose the bed foot the papa and drop on you. Why is this devil love on that bed so much? Them love on that bed, them love on that car. Anyway. Based on what me at here, cause, hey, this not nothing to do with me. Let's make it clear. Let me put this out there right now, cause I know the conspiracy theories are gonna start. It is a complete coincidence that after Muta continuously threatened my family, threatening me, say I'm gonna kill me. What the year done. That something like this happened to him. And even though obviously I didn't make a video Friday or Saturday, and on Saturday this happened, it is also a complete coincidence that that was the same day Muta get him face kicking by accident, of course. This is a complete coincidence. Muta, this now have nothing to do with me, my lad. My boss. My Dan. Jenna, Killy. Bro God. Muta. Your message has been received loud and clear. Nobody can get to you, nobody can find you. You're the biggest bad man that's in catching right now. You're not taking no more talk from the system, you're doing your own thing. Muta, your message has been received loud and clear. But one thing though, Muta, it kind of disappoints me. Because based on what I'm hearing, because me said it's not nothing to do with me. Let me repeat that. But based on what I'm hearing, Muta, the way that go on in time, they get drawn from under the bed. I'm very surprised. Muta, you're a murderer. Mama, you're a murderer, ball. Muta? Muta will kill much people. I was expecting a much different scenario. A much different scenario when I tell you these 87s. When them have the gun and you have it. Them are the baddest thing alive. But when a time for the action, them fall up like a launch here. Muta. And don't worry, Muta. I'm not going to talk because my things are going to talk. Just keep that between me and you, bro. Big bro. My dad, my boss. Jenna. Killy. We keep certain things. I'm not gonna make Waterloo Lane, man. Them, you know, some of the things I'm gonna say. In your desperate moment. Because you think so, that was going to be the end of it, wasn't it, Muta? You think so, that was it. You think so, boy, did them draw me out now that I last day upon earth? No, it wasn't, Muta. It wasn't, look, Muta. See, Muta, I forgive you, bro. I forgive you. Threatening the murder of my family. It's a step too far. Even my dog. Poor little dog. What that dog do you, Muta? Nothing. But I forgive you, Muta. I forgive you. And nobody has to stress out too much in the Muta. I bring in the way I get bring in. No worry, man. You're not going to do that for long. you won't be there very long, Amuta. But you see the bad thing? We got Cosmo. Now you make me have to go shine the light over Waterloo Lane faster than I expected. Remember me tell people about River Valley and for the food stock on River Valley, much shut off for River Valley, much people are dead. And I was going to come towards River Valley and in place and talk about it eventually, but now, since Muta wants to entreat and Muta say I'm a killer. If we shine the light first, so now Muta get other people in a problem. Can you see Muta brother? I have two brothers, Smokey and Izzy. Even though them they behind bars, them still are saying out word. I wonder which brother I should focus on first. How about Smokey? Nah, I really. Hezzy are the real murderer one. Hezzy, well, I'm a murderer, but Hezzy theme thing kinda extreme. Smokey and Izzy wanna really make Muta come take up badness. After wanna see him to Papu, after wanna see him to Crackers. Wanna really make Muta, wanna really make gun reaching a Muta on. Izzy. Wanna really make little Muta come bad though. So the whole family that. From father come shooting the line. Wanna really go make Muta end up like Papu. Okay, see, Muta ain't a problem now, you know. Right now, if Muta drop, nobody even know who. Because he go say him a do him own thing and him not take no talk. Tesha side want him. Black man side want him. All of the people him, who him kill. For them loved ones, them want him. Right now, Muta probably safer behind bars. So when you get look at Muta, you know, because I fail to keep a leash on the dog. I know the mongrel dog, I threaten my mongrel dog. Hezzy. Boy, your track record long. A whole bunch of people you killed. Not even half of them get mentioned when the anti-gang trial will come up. But it's like how Muta so brave and bold. Muta getting no problem now. And does you neither. You see all Talis? Yes, Talis was sending money for Muta. So Muta then can buy a shot. So Muta get Talis no problem now. Cause it's not just about the Muta. Muta can't operate with a support system. I will know Muta is a puppet. When him get the message from prison, he will carry them out. But where the funding will come from? We know where the funding will come from. Isn't that right, Talis? By the way, how the foot? Get better yet? Can I walk and run good again? Talis? So Muta get in a problem in a Talis. Or should I refer to you as Dave? Because you think you're safe. Think you're safe because you know they're on the block. You think the waters, because the water is separated from Jamaica, you can't get found. You see the threat them Uno sent to me, the threat them if you send to Uno. Because the man said, wait till you find out where they. Well, guess what? I know where they are already. Isn't that right, Dave? Satalis. I wonder when I should drop your video. You probably have prepared the money right now for bail out the Muta. Dave. I wonder when I should drop your video. We'll fit in at the schedule. You see, not even Pricky Boy was foolish enough to do things like this. At least him just make it known, say my watch and him tune in regular. He wasn't foolish enough to threaten my family. As me say, it was a complete coincidence that it just so happened that the day But then go for the commuter. Was the day I didn't post. I also want to put it on record that I am definitely the type of person that responds well to threats. And if any member of the Klansman gang or any other gang for that matter want me to not talk about them and not shine a light upon them, the best way to do that is to threaten me. I respond very well to threats. I'm also the type of person that take drape up and box up. I am also a well-known pacifist. I do not deal with self-defense. So I encourage the members of the Klansman gang, as me say, any gang for that matter, please publicly state what you're going to do to me and the people I care about. Because, well, nothing not gonna happen. Nothing not gonna happen. I know some people have said, Sir Pierce, I said that, are you? Let me repeat it again. I had nothing to do with what happened with Lukumuta. Everything is just complete coincidence. Complete coincidence. But you see, sometimes when certain people are protected, when certain people are being watched over, every time you speak ill of those people, just the words will come out of your mouth, bad things happen to you. No weapon that rise against Sir P shall prosper. None. Mute, you soon come back around, man. You soon come back around. But the one thing, man, know. You see them little 87s that were hiding on the bed and go on and put on all the excitement when they think they're going to be dead. Them can't manage pressure. So, make you see which pieces of the puzzle get filled in by the time Muta touch back the road. Now I want you to look at your screen right now. This is one of the reasons why Muta did a walk up and down so, because him thinks say him couldn't get fine. See, Muta had a little change of appearance. That's Muta originally, right, how him normally look on the left. Right. But on the right, it's almost like a complete different person. Muta completely bleached out his skin. One of the easiest tricks 87s pull off. Look like a completely different person, right? Although the picture up on the right, you know, is heavily filtered because, you know, these 87s, these modern day 87s, when they go up on them IG page, they have all kind of butterfly and thing on them face and, you know, well filtered down. They know the best filters, they know the filters them better than the woman them. As you can see, Muta. And brown man now. Only thing is, Muta want to work on the finger them look more. But yeah, complete different youth. Then when you add it to the facts, right, certain place on a Waterloo Lane, hard for the security forces to get it running upon them. That's one of the reasons why Muta still alive too, because as me say, even though enough other 87 want him, the lane is like a fortress. And even within the lane, no for the little spots them, nobody no know about. Well, that's what Muta thinks. And even when he left the lane, they could carry a scene in about the place. Nobody no know about him. Well, that's what Muta thinks. So, keep your head up, little Muta. As me say, I forgive you. Forgive and forget, right? Right? See, the way how people like Muta thrive is by controlling people through fear. Waterloo Lane inside River the World in place there. Afraid of Muta and him team. Afraid of them. People even make eye contact in the wrong way. I beat up big people like Sima Pitney. Shot people call them quote unquote diss them. And some and all the diss entail is a heel with them not like. Right, the heel sound like say. They never want to hear all kind of foolishness. This might sound fascinating to people who don't come from them places, but people who live there know me at all about. The days when time when look at run Spanish Town and do what I feel like and the bad man will go on and go on and look at can go hide, them days are done. Cause I go like say on a bakra. And I go like say people live on some kind of plantation and they can control them every move and them every step. Them days are finito. Finito. Now una go feel the pressure. Wanna put poor people under on a daily basis. Well, let me leave this one right just for now. There definitely will be a follow-up. You can bet on that. Patreon squad. You open yourself. I know what I already have seen. The post I made about this on Patreon. Right. From last night. Well, I look at conversation about it. You open yourself. PIA. You don't know. More life. Vulture Squad, stay circling as always. Bless.